raining fucking cats and dogs out here. Guess it's time to hit the library, eh?
I am on a quest to understand and master high-level mathematics. I tried university to get this done, but it wasn't the answer. And so I've left it to venture out on my own to find the knowledge I desire. Self-educating. Using whatever resources I can find, documenting my journey as I go in order to help you in yours. The mountain is high and the path is long. So let's get to climbing. All right, adventure hat is on. You know what that means. It's adventure time, baby. So one of the most daunting tasks of the self-education journey is wandering the math shelves and just seeing how little you really know. So if you can see, we got one shelf, two shelves, three shelves, four, and all of them are chocked to the brim with titles in math, most of which I have no idea what they are. However, that is just what we do. You gotta face the storm, so let's get tropical. Also, we got a bunch of math videos coming up. Differential equations, one of them. Derivatives, another one. Integrals, another one. Abstract algebra, another one. A few others. But if you have any requests, put them in the comments. We don't have a huge viewership, so if you actually do have a request and put it in the comments, it's likely gonna get done. One of the hypest things about the self-education journey is starting off having no idea what a title is, being intimidated by it. And then after time, after stumbling along, you start figuring out what the titles mean. Even though you don't know the topic, you're still like, hey, I kinda know what that is. For example, that, no idea what it is, but kind of an idea of what it's saying. I know what that is.
Literally nothing but bacon and cheese in there.
Is it the thick bacon?
Oil.
Carb.
So I forgot I have to go to trivia night with a couple of buddies at a local pub, but I'm a Canadian, not a Cantonadian, and so we're gonna do both this and go. I picked up a classic text in calculus, just to quickly go over, and have a bit of a rant to go on, 30 seconds. They usually open up with talking about properties of numbers, which is totally unintuitive to people who haven't had any exposure to abstract algebra. And so if any of you are trying to learn real analysis right now, all I can say is imagine the numbers from a set perspective. Once you start thinking in sets, in terms of the sets of things that we define operations on, it becomes a lot clearer. The intuitive idea of numbers, when you go back, it was accepted for a long time, arithmetic and the properties of the real numbers and how you operate on them, like the typical grade school algebra and stuff, and it wasn't a big deal. Fast forward a little bit, people started analyzing it, analyzing what are the numbers, what are their properties, because when you go to the same time period, they were looking at sets and relations between elements of sets, and they applied that logic to the numbers. It wasn't just this thing that they came up with, but when they present it, they don't give you that other aspect of looking at things just as sets and how the elements of the set relate. I'm gonna do a whole bit on this, but that's just what I wanted to get across. If you're looking at these, this scared the hell out of me when I was doing it first, like what, they just pull out random numbers or random properties of numbers and arithmetic, and you're like, how do they come up with this? Like just some random property, and they say just accept it, this is an axiom of the arithmetic. Like, how did you get there? This makes no sense at all. Like, if I was a mathematician back in the day, they wouldn't show me how I would get there. It's just this, like, if you're looking at it, just think sets, relationship between the elements of that set, and then apply that thinking to the real numbers. But at the end of the day, it's not that important for some stuff. I would recommend doing a little introduction to algebra first, abstract algebra, before diving in, because it helps with understanding the properties of sets and relations on those sets. All right.
Quite a buzz around here. Did he ask you to sign his Captain America?